Hi, welcome to Big Ted's Home and Garden. In this video, I'm going to show you how to descale your Nespresso coffee machine without having to spend a ridiculous amount of money on Nespresso's descaling solution. Limescale is a buildup of calcium carbonate due to calcium salts in your water. It can happen to all machines, but it's particularly bad in hard water areas. Now, the problem with it is it can affect the longevity of your machine, and it also tastes pretty grim if it flakes off and ends up in your coffee. So if you want great tasting coffee and you want your machine to last a long time, you need to descale it regularly. Nespresso recommend that you descale your machine every 3 months or after every 300 pods. Nespresso do sell their own descaling solution, but the problem is it's very, very expensive. Here in the UK, we're looking at £7 plus £5 postage for two treatments. If you buy it on Amazon, I think it's round about £11 for two treatments. The method I'm going to show you should cost less than 20 pence, or around about 25 cents for our American friends. To get rid of limescale, you need to get it to react with an acidic solution to form a soluble salt which will dissolve in water, which you can then wash away. From their website, it appears that Nespresso use lactic acid, but we're going to use citric acid. This will react with the calcium carbonate to form calcium citrate, which is soluble in water. Citric acid is a natural non-toxic substance that you find in all citrus fruits like oranges and lemons. It's easy to get hold of and it's really cheap. I get mine from eBay. I'll put a link in the description below, but yesterday I think I paid just over £4 for 500 grams delivered. You only actually need about 20 grams of citric acid every time you descale your Nespresso machine, but there are loads of other uses for citric acid as well. I also use citric acid for descaling my other kettles. I use it in brewing, wine making, jam making. You can use citric acid to make bath bombs, and you can even use it to clean your carpets. But my favourite is to use it to make homemade lemonade. Now, some people recommend using white vinegar as an alternative descaler. Like citric acid, vinegar's cheap, but it's a little bit more aggressive. It's based on ethanoic acid, and also it leaves an aftertaste, whereas citric acid doesn't. Before I show you how to descale your Nespresso machine, I'd be really grateful if you'd consider subscribing to my channel. You can just click the button down below. It costs you nothing, but it makes a massive difference to small channels like mine. So the first thing we need to do is make up our descaling solution. To do this, we're going to add 1 tablespoon of citric acid. That's about 20 grams to 500 milliliters of water, or about a pint, and then stir until it dissolves. You then need to remove the water tank from the back of your machine and completely empty it. Take the empty tank and pour the citric acid descaling solution into it, and it will be roughly half full. Like that. You can then refit the water tank to the back of the Nespresso machine. Once the water tank's installed, remove the milk frother from the front of the machine. And in the front of the frother stand, you'll find the descaling nozzle. This nozzle fits into the milk frother inlet like this. You'll need to collect the descaling solution as it passes through the machine, so pull out the cup stand and place a container big enough to hold at least 500 millilitres of water underneath both nozzles. To start the descaling process, press the warm milk froth button and the cleaning solution will start to pass alternatively through the coffee outlet, the descaling nozzle and the drip tray. It does this until the tank is empty. You can then remove the container that you've been collecting the descaling solution in and take out the drip tray, because there'll be a small amount of fluid in the bottom of that as well. That needs draining. And pour it away, it's harmless. Rinse and refill your water tank up to maximum capacity and refit it. And then run the descaling program again to rinse out the machine. The rinse cycle runs until it empties the tank. Repeat the process of removing the collection container and emptying the drip tray. You can now put everything back together. The descaling nozzle fits back into the front of the milk frother stand. clip the milk frother back into place, and you're ready to go. Well, for roughly the cost of one pod, you'll have better tasting coffee and your machine should last longer. So I hope you found this useful. If you have, leave a thumbs up. If you've got any questions, leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to Big Ted's Home and Garden. We'll see you soon.